Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genji and I'm here with a new video of the parametric design series in Dynamo Revit. So far we talked a lot about grids, about cubes, circles and so on. Today we're gonna try some other solid geometries such as cones. So we're gonna see how we can create some patterns such as this one or this one made out of cones. Under the geometry tab here, we tried surfaces and curves before. Let's take a look at the solids part in here. The first option here is the cone. I have already set up a vertical grid. You know how to do that. It's on the XZ plane as you see here. Let's take a look at the cone options. I'm gonna use one of the point-based options for the cone, maybe this one, which creates a cone with axis from start point to end point. And then you can change the radius at the beginning and at the end. So you see there's a cone over there. It's actually a cylinder because the start and end radius are the same by default. They're both set on one. So if I assign the base point off the grid to the start point, it's gonna create some cones here, but all of them are actually going to one hypothetical endpoint, which is 0, 0, 1. Now I'm gonna change that endpoint and see how it's gonna work. Let's consider a pattern like this, for instance. So you see in this case, the start point is the XZ plane itself. The end point is again on a vertical plane, just moved a little bit around the Y axis. So what I'm gonna do is that I want to disconnect this first for now. I want to translate this geometry and move it a little bit away on the Y axis, which is perpendicular to this XZ plane. And I want to use the second set of grids as the endpoint. So I'm going to use the move or translate option. What do I want to translate? The grid. So the points go to the geometry. I want to translate it in the y direction because it's on one XZ plane. I'm going to use the y direction here. I'll put just some number for now and I will assign it to Y. So now I have two sets of parallel surfaces. Now if I use the first set of points as for the start point of the cone and use the second geometry, the translated points, as for the end point of the cones, is going to create 600 cones with a radius of 1 at both at the beginning and at the end. If we take a look at the settings here, both the start and the end radius are set on 1. I might use a couple of number sliders or code blocks to change the values here. Maybe I should go with a number between 0 and 1 and assign it to the start point. I'm gonna copy and paste the number slider and assign a different number to the end radius. Let's say if I change the end radius to 0, they're gonna be some cones now. Let's make the start radius to be smaller, and I can hide this set of points so we can see better. If the end number is not 0 but something like 0.2, it's gonna be like some cut cones, right? Now we can play a lot with this. We can create an attractor line, such as this case. You see a hypothetical line goes from that corner to that corner, and it's the attractor line in here. How about I turn the preview off here first and turn the preview on here. Just like before, we're gonna start with a point. Point by coordinate is good. It's on 0, 0. How about I bring a second point? And I'm gonna name these two as point attractor number one and point attractor number two. Then I'm gonna create a line by start and end point. So it's gonna be my attractor line. They're actually on top of each other, that's why it was not able to create a line. Let me rename this as line attractor. Okay. So if this point is around there, how about I consider one point maybe around there? In that case, I need to change the X and Z of the second point. So I'm gonna assign maybe 10 to both X and Z of the second point. Now it's there. How about I assign 12, 13 or 15? 15 is good. And I want to go with a different code block for the Z. It should be somewhere around like 20. I'm gonna assign it to the Z. Almost there. 23. Okay, I can go with 22 and I can go with 14 in here. Okay, so now this could be my attractor line, and I want to change the radius of the cones based on how close they are to the attractor line. How about I group these items here? Name them as attractor down there. Okay, now like before, I need to get the distance between the first set of points here and the attractor line. Let's type distance, get distance, and I want to get the distance between the first grid and the line. As I have 600 points, I should have 600 elements here as well. We have 600 numbers here. As you see, they are somehow very large, so I want to use division to come up with some smaller numbers. I want to divide this number by some number, maybe 8. And I want to use this second list as the start point of the cones. I need to turn the cones back on. I'm gonna delete this number slider and keep this one. How about I also unpin these two so I have more room, and assign one number slider to this number, number slider. I can go with some number larger than 1 to maybe 50. Assign it to Y here. The larger this number, the smaller the cones will be. For instance, if I change this from 15 to like 20, the cones will be smaller here. I can also change the end radius. If I change it back to 0, it's gonna be a very steep cone. Or I could put it on 0.1, 0.2, and so on. I would also like to hide this set of points. And you see this icon is kind of orange now. It's telling me that it failed to create some cones where the radius was zero or negative. That's okay. It's not a serious warning. It's a good idea to also hide the attractor line and the 2 points creating the attractor line. We could also hide the grid here, and this would be the outcome. And any of the inputs you change here is going to affect the shape of the pattern. For instance, you remember we copied and translated the first grid by 1 meter away. If I change this to like 0.5 or something, it's going to affect the form of the grids. You can change the grid size, the distance between the points, and so on.